Kakar us have arrived in Lisbon, Portugal. So we are here for our honeymoon! But before anything else, make sure to subscribe to my channel and click on that
bell button to get notified when a new video comes out every Saturday at 10 a.m. Philippine time and every second week on Wednesdays.
We spent a few days in Florence to chill.
It wasn't so chill though, thanks to Lorraine Wee and Mickey Cruz.
Yeah, but we were supposed to just chill and just do nothing, have no plans, no itinerary, no anything. And that is why you won't see a vlog from there, because I was on a day off. After spending a few days in Florence, we've decided to come to Portugal, just do a road trip here. And we have a partnership with Hertz, which makes our road trip possible. I'm in this cardio. First 5 minutes, cardio na agad. What are you trying to say?
I refuse to answer.
My tummy is happy. So this trip is something new to me because I was so busy planning the wedding and I had so many things on my mind. I feel like my brain is now shut down and I have no more capacity to plan anything else. I have asked Yoni to plan everything for our tours and he plans everything the European kind of way. So he's like, okay, let's plan it on the day itself. I'm really not used to it because I'm so Chinese. I feel like I have to fix something, but I'm stopping myself because my brain is really in no capacity to plan anything anymore. So it feels really something new because I have no idea where we're going.
Just take it easy, don't stress about it. See what we see.
Cute spots, cute restaurants, yummy food. What is that? You holding hands? We were just doing this the entire time. Because you know, every marriage is a partnership. Driver, are you happy with our car?
It's good.
Do you feel like a local?
Yes, it's a small enough for these streets.
It's a BMW 1 Series and according to the guy at Hertz, it has just come out of the shop. But when we got it, it was only at 8 kilometers,
correct,
right? So we've always said that one of our dreams is to do a road trip here in Europe. So that's what we're gonna do now! But first, we must look for a parking slot for this baby while we're here in Lisbon because everything is so walkable here. I mean, we're right in the city center. Oh, it's Game of Thrones, can you hear? That's the Museum of Beer, beer, beer.
Run.
I've lost my husband. Ay nako, problem siya. Look, a surprise gift for our honeymoon. Yay! Dessert, peanuts, strawberries, and
Prosecco.
Cheers. Oh, it's good.
Fresh.
Your face was like this, Joah. Fresh. Detox continues.
It's day two in Lisbon and we're strolling around the street. It started to rain a bit, but luckily Madam has her newly purchased, what is it?
Gucci bucket hat. And it's really solid because it's reversible.
Mm-hmm. Is it protecting you from the rain?
Yes, it is. I am well protected.
Good for you.
So we're currently at LX Factory.
What was this before?
It is a factory.
Poor tour guide, this one. No history whatsoever.
So LX Factory is now one of their coolest, hippest quarters. And we're coming here to check out a lot of different cool stores and cafes and stuff. It's a really hip neighborhood. But first, we must eat at Wish. Apparently, they serve really, really good coffee there. It's a specialty coffee place.
That's really funny.
You can eat now.
This was loose when we started.
Sorry.
Next one for me. If I light it up, Joa.
Then I have to react.
Yes, you have to.
So we need that in every room.
Ever I'm vlogging, it'll be turning on, so it means you can't go in quite on the set. Yes?
No. I lost the Joa, but then surprisingly found her in a vintage store. I thought I lost you.
It's a cool vintage store. You get most of your stuff from the States and in the UK. And I got a genuine, like a red poofy leather jacket. And it's only for 85 euros for a genuine leather jacket. It's
5,000 pesos.
Thanks, Haba. Prettiest sardine store ever. And they've got really, really cool stuff here. Like, for example, they're most well known for their sardines. And if you look at it, it says here like what city they've discovered, and you have the year over there for when that happened. So cool. So they've got different trivia on each type of fish that they're selling. Bought some for souvenirs for my parents. The Joa has the souvenirs. The Joa has left me.
And we're about to meet Yanni's friend Sonia, who's also Finnish, but she's usually here in Portugal. And she says Taimaad Market is one of the best places to eat here in Lisbon. They have a lot of different stalls of like really famous chefs here, so you can eat from different stalls and then just order and then everything's just there at your table. And I'm really excited because when I googled it, it's huge. Are you excited, Joa?
I'm excited for a huge pizza.
I want real Portuguese food and rice. You said we wanted to try custard, right? Look, custard.
It's like a big hawker in Singapore or Malaysia, but indoors. Good shot.
Yes.
Oh, it looks delish.
We're now here with Sonia, Yanni's friend, and now my friend too. So she's been telling us about Taimaad Market, and these are our choices for now. This is the
pork pelicon
from Alexander Silva
from
over there. He's apparently a Michelin star chef. And then we have over here octopus hot dog, which was recommended by our neighbor over here, but maybe he doesn't want to be seen. So it's from here, Simi. And the third one is
seafood risotto.
Seafood
what?
Swordfish. Yes, and that one also comes from another Michelin star chef.
But it has coriander.
Vera. But this one, a lot of people seem to get jealous of. So many people asked Sonia about her dish already. I'm also jealous, but it has shrimp, so I can eat it. So now it's time to feast. You may eat now.
Good morning. So today is day 3 here in Lisbon. It's currently 14 degrees Celsius and everyone's in puffer jackets. But I am strong. It's gonna be 19 degrees later anyways. And I'm not cold yet. Usually not cold in the morning because I'm hot.
But I do have thermals on. It's not heat tech,
but it's okay. I really am not cold yet. Hopefully it doesn't get cold later. We finally made it. We're now walking at
Peña Park.
Peña Park on the way to the Peña Palace.
Just up, high up.
If you read through like mga blogs and stuff, they would always tell you not to bring a car because it's hard to find parking. But for us, we brought a car because it's not peak season yet. Because of traffic, it gets around like from city center of Sintra, it's 30 minutes because of the traffic. And then we were able to find parking
right next to the park entrance, which was good because apparently this is the only way to the palace.
But the queue for the tickets is also super duper long, but you can easily buy it online on the spot. So that's what we did, so we didn't have to wait, and we got instant confirmation, and now we're on the way to the palace in my dress,
hiking shoes and dress.
As I've said, I did not research on the way here, and the husband did not tell me that we had to walk a lot.
Oopsies.
It's the Moorish castle right there. Ta-da! I'm still here at the Peña Palace. And the Joa is testing my Huawei. Does it work?
Whoa.
Cray. The zoom is cray. I'm gonna show you something.
Did you engrave that?
I engraved your name. See?
Thanks. Why is there an E in my heart?
Are you touched? What? An E? No, that's someone else, but I engraved this.
Uh-huh. Did you come here yesterday?
Yeah.
Nice surprise. Thanks.
Yes, you're welcome.
Touched.
How about me? How come you didn't?
Hanap show.
I have to find it. Where is it? I give up.
No, you can't give up.
Saan? Grabe show. It's not fair. Ay, nako, Joa.
I don't know what's happening, but so many Chinese tourists have like color coordinated outfits. They have like a yellow group there and a green group there, and I saw a blue group as well. And I'm just beyond amazed.
I wish I thought of that too.
They're
dedicated. Didn't
you don't research these places.
The Moorish castle is right over there. So from where we're parked, the other way goes to the Moorish castle, which is this one. So this is the trail. It's sort of like a trekking, hiking thing. So of course we're not gonna go for obvious reasons. But Yanni and I was just talking, and we feel like it kind of reminds us of the
Great Wall of China, which I have conquered already.
Yes, and he doesn't want any more walls.
No, all the walls have been kicked out.
The latest being?
Camille Paul.
Okay, so I am filming this just for your viewing pleasure, presenting the Moorish Castle.
We are on to our third palace, which is called the Quinta da Regalera. Nailed it. So we thought it was a really small place, but apparently it's not. Also, there was a line, but this one you can't buy the tickets online. You can only buy them here, but the line was pretty fast moving. But I don't know if it's because we came a bit later. It's already around 5 plus p.m. Maybe if you come a bit earlier, it's gonna be busier as well.
Hard life, too many people standing there in their frame.
Every corner of this place feels like you're walking through a Disney book. I mean, look, ganda. I mean, how can this even be real? Thanks for buying me this house.
It's not as modern as you wished, but I thought you
it's good enough.
Like it because there are a lot of
oh, look at that sun flare. A little bit here, there. Oh yeah, oh yes, artsy.
Same struggles continue.
Now we're finally inside. So this is basically their sala. So this is the initials of the family. So nice, it's all over the room.
Apparently I parked too far. This was the last 25 meters and she refused to walk. Okay, you pick me up here when you come. That's the true madam, right there. Better go now.
This restaurant reminds me of a restaurant that we've been to in Salzburg. And I would like to show you our his and hers. Mali. His and hers. We're tired, okay? But the Joel is very disappointed with his beer.
I was ordering a lager, and then he asked if I want a smaller or a big one. I said, of course, big one. And then he comes with a light beer. And I eat light beer. And now I'm struggling with this.
Mine is perfect. Perfect white wine. Keep these. Our starters, mushroom and salmon. Attack.
That was honestly such a good meal. So if you come to Sintra, you have to try it out. It's in Kamom, I think. That's how you pronounce it. But a few tips before I end our vlog for the day. Only for the day. If you're bringing a car, it's totally fine. Unless maybe when it's super peak, which is during the summer. If not, you can bring your own car if you don't want to commute. I think it's going to take as much time as if you commute and ride the bus. Because you're going through the same route anyways. So it's super same. In terms of all the palaces here, I think it's better for you to start early. Like you really have to be here by 10 a.m. to avoid all the long lines. But you will encounter a line in some other palace. But the first palace that you must visit is definitely the Benya Palace, because that is the most crowded out of all the palaces. According to a review I read online, if you go there at 10 a.m. when it opens, then it's not as crowded. But if you can't, you're not a morning person, that's totally fine. It's all about just looking for the best angles to make it seem like you have the palace to yourself.
But the thing was that we bought the ticket to the park and bought the ticket to the palace. But then when we got to the palace, the queue to go in was probably, what, 2-3 hours?
Yeah, so which is why even if we bought the ticket to go into the palace, we weren't able to use it anyways because it would have taken up our entire day. If you just want to take photos of the palace, then just get the park ticket. That's fine already. That is a tip from the Kohoros.
Over and out.
Good afternoon. It's already currently 12 noon. We went out a little bit later because we were hoping the rain would stop by now, but it hasn't. Hopefully the rain stops though. If you notice, I'm wearing my new purchase from the other day. So this is the jacket that I bought from the vintage store. It's super cute, right? And now we're on the way to our lunch place that I researched. The food isn't that good.
No.
No. But there is a tapas side, which is this one. It's the first one that you see when you enter. I feel like maybe that's what's causing all the good reviews because it's much, much more full.
So we're currently walking around the Alfama neighborhood. So it's like the old quarters here in this Bon. This is here still so in their old architecture. Correct? That you'll see a lot of here in this spot are the Miradoros. So you'll see that all over in maps, Google Maps, in everywhere, because they have a lot of those viewpoints. So basically Miradoro means viewpoint, right?
Am I inventing stuff?
But if you see that, then it means that you'll get to see a really nice view of Lisbon from there. So people usually go to all these different spots and you'll see all the pretty colors. Update, update. It's finally a bit sunny, but we've lost our umbrella.
So we were shooting.
We were shooting with the famous tram because I wanted a shot with the tram.
So I abandoned the umbrella for a minute.
For then, 100 minutes.
And then when I turn around, some freaking thief has stolen our umbrella.
Right.
My heels.
Right between his feet.
That gutsy one.
Exactly.
So it better shine for the rest of the day.
Well, at least of all the things that we can lose today, the umbrella is okay lang na mawala. So that's your thief. I hope you're happy with your umbrella, thief.
We're gonna find you.
We're gonna cut you. No, just kidding. Okay, so now we're walking to Mantegaria, which is apparently where the best egg tarts are. It's the same egg tart place that we got in the timeout market, but the ones that we got from the timeout market were not served hot to us, which is why I said the ones from Macau is still the best. But according to Yanni's friend Sonia, they serve it always hot from here, so we're gonna give it another chance just to see if it really is the best egg tart in the world. Right, Toa? Yes, it is hot.
The moment of truth. Is it hot?
So much better here.
How about compared to Macau? Approved. Original is the winner.
What did you just say?
It's much better.
It's really good, right? It's milkier, less sweet.
What did we forget?
Cinnamon. You have to add cinnamon.
That's your last bite though. What if it's not good? Well, the cinnamon is hot. Struggling. The struggle is real. I think you have to get another one. Better with or without.
But what's the cinnamon that has like some spice to it? My tongue is very worth it. So we've been chasing tram after tram for my Insta shot. Only to find a tram that's parked here with the best view. And we only figured it out because we saw all these people taking photos here and it's like, let's look at this. So it pays to be chismosa, Joa.
Actually.
It pays to be chismosa. So we have so much time that I looked for a cocktail place called Park. It's situated right above this garage. Shady looking.
The parking guy who Yanni went approached, he knew right away that we were gonna ask him about Park.
Go to the bar.
Yes! We found it! So this is the type of place that Yanni and I really like. The one that's got a very chill vibe. They've got music. They've got a really good view. Kind of reminds me of Stockholm actually. One of the bars that we went to there. It's that type of place that we're always looking for whenever we travel. It's super chill lounge. It's nothing pretentious. Very laid back.
Jog it. Jog it. No. Some left. Go. Yeah, my girl. Okay, and then the next one. Jog. Nona.
What are your plans? Why are you making me chug this? Stop it for 53 minutes. So, the husband, no longer the Joa. I have to learn to say husband instead of Joa. The hubba is very, 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 very cold. So, being the very, very, very loving and caring wife that I am, I decided to give him warm.
Warmers.
You're welcome. Us. And this restaurant is supposed to be really trendy and it looks so pretty. You guys, Hopefully the food is as good. They also have boutiques here. Gandol. So we read reviews and people are saying that this is a good restaurant. And of course it's for gin lovers, which Yoni and I are. But guys, look at the prices. It's as expensive as a meal. But we're on our honeymoon, so we're gonna indulge. So inside that area is the gin place. So people are just drinking cocktails, standing up, and then all over the building. You see lots of different stores and boutiques. And on the topmost floor, there's a spa. And this is the dinner area. It's a really pretty place.
I now know why it's the most expensive gin place ever.
It's so heavy. Busog na busog siya.
So lit?
Yes.
You haven't tried it yet. Maybe it's only ice. It's not only ice.
Oh, there's a drink there.
So today's our last day here at this spot. So we pulled out all the stops when it came to brunch. Yoni found this really cute cafe called Dear Breakfast. It's so cute. It was just really hard for Yoni to find parking. And there was a line outside, but we got lucky. He beat the stars.
And all their stuff are, unfortunately, Gooby copies, which is one of the brands that we sell in Curio Cavern. It does. And look, those legs are Gooby.
But it's not Jerry's stuff, it's not a copy. It's a different design.
Okay, it is heavily inspired by Gooby. But yeah, the place is so cute. And the food looks amazing too, Joa. I ordered for us. Yes, because it took you so long. I ordered avocado toast.
That's a good choice.
Check, quinoa bowl.
Perfect.
And I got us a sweet pancake. And then I also got myself a pink latte, which I asked the waiter if it was just a pink coffee. But he said no. It's actually a lot of fruits and herbs and coffee, stuff like that. It looks good. It's here. It looks so good. Yes. For dessert, pancakes. Oh my god, good luck! So before leaving Lisbon, we decided to stop by this place first because they say na mas masarap daw yung egg tarts nila here than the ones we ate yesterday. And girl, look at this line, it's crazy. My god, my gosh. Yay, got them! So I just wanna emphasize again how long the queue was. I was there, my god.
But it was really, really fast and efficient. And when I got to the cashier, I asked him, I said, is it warm? Is it hot? And then he says, always. As if he was insulted that I asked. I made sure to get extra cinnamon for us as well. And the girl who was serving it said, you like cinnamon? Yes, extra please, more.
How is the looks compared to Mantai Kashi?
The looks like they're identical.
How about the smell?
To test it.
And then
it
the
smells crunchy. So good.
No.
I honestly think they're both good. I can't even tell the difference. Or maybe it's just me.
The dough is harder in this one.
The food critic. And then?
It's more eggy. I think the other one is sweeter.
This is less sweet, that is true.
The other one is more vanilla.
And now with cinnamon. Oh, crunchy.
So we've got a road trip food. Our bags are all packed. Well, we don't have just one bag. We have lots of bags at the back. Because we're all packed up, ready to leave Lisbon. Even though I love Lisbon. We love Lisbon, right?
Yeah, it was nice.
And now we're gonna stay for one night in Aveiro, or just a little bit outside Aveiro, to go around Aveiro and Costa Nova before we head on to Porto. As I've said before, it's always been a dream of Yoni and I to do like a road trip around Europe. So we're doing it now for our honeymoon. In case I wasn't able to mention it, we rented our car from Hertz. Hertz is a global brand, so you can rent it anywhere you are in the world. It's usually available in city centers or at the airports. We got ours at the airport because we landed in this one through the airport. But we're gonna drop it off in Porto so that we don't have to worry about the car anymore. But this is a perfect way for us to travel because we're also gonna stop by a wine city called Douro. And we're gonna have this car with us all throughout. And Yanni's already loving it actually.
No, trick
we're
you.
At Obidos. So we did a quick stop before we get to Aveiro. So Obidos is also a UNESCO World Heritage Site, just like Sintra. And it looks super duper charming based on the flyer that my Joba got.
The wall going around the city has opened it up. And we're gonna explore what's here.
But I was still vlogging here. But I was still like, he's saying something. A responsible vlogger has made so much dedicated.
Before we explore, the Joa must attend to my injuries. He's not happy about this.
This is at least big enough.
Don't. There you go. Tightly, please. Properly.
Beautiful.
Perfect. Oh no, it's so big.
You pulled a big. I think she exaggerated her injury slightly.
No, I just asked for a band-aid and this is what they gave me.
At the pharmacy because they gave a band-aid which covers her whole feet. So a bit too much drama.
I'm never dramatic.
Where's Joa? Joa is here with a tourist group listening at the background. The cheapest tour ever. Oh, you brought your camera crew. I'm not needed, sorry.
This is the castle, but it's very dangerous to climb up.
Well, it doesn't look that dangerous. You wanna go?
I think these are cuter.
Okay. Oh no, shopping.
No, I wanted to buy a souvenir. And this one's like the sidewalk in Rocio. And this one.
Approved.
So that was just a really, really quick stop at Olmedos. Like the entire city is walled. I'm gonna Google why. But it was a really charming city. It reminds me of all the small Spanish cities that we've been to, like Sitges or Sevilla, like the old quarters of Sevilla. It's super duper 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 cute. And if we did wake up earlier, then it would have been nice to have lunch there because all the food smelled amazing. But as Yanni and I have been saying, this is our honeymoon. We're not in a hurry. We just want to chill. If we don't wake up, we don't wake up.
Exactly. No rushing to places.
No pressure.
Nope. Yeah.
And now we're off to Costa Nova. It's a really, really cute beach with really cute fisherman houses, which is why I am dressed in a super colorful outfit. Like a dasha bash.
We have the cutest houses here in Costa Nova. Girl, it's like, are they even real?
How is this neighborhood real?
People actually live here. This place is insane. It's crazy. I feel like I'm in Pleasantville. Oh, how on earth does this exist? And after a quick 10-minute drive, we're now in Italy!
Venice!
Now, this is actually called Aveiro, and Aveiro is often called the Venice of Portugal. They have their own version of a gondola. They have a term for it. I will not try to pronounce it. It looks difficult to pronounce, but it's much, 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 much more affordable than a gondola ride. They say it's around like 7 euros per person. Still trying to convince the Joa to do it with me, but he doesn't want. It's our honeymoon. From one bridge to another.
Correct. From bridge hunters.
Bridge hunters. We've been making selfies per bridge.
Hey, my face.
That's artsy.
Doesn't this place remind you of Burano?
So cute.
Dinner at Aveiro, and they welcomed us with Prosecco, and she said that if it's okay, and I said of course it's okay, any offer is okay. And they have the cutest little placemat. It's like typical people now of Aveiro, like this one, the neighbor, Miss Rosa, that she smells a neighbor who knows everything.
Good morning, another day, another road trip from Aveiro. We're now headed to Douro, where we're gonna do a bunch of wine tasting. We're gonna get drunk and lit and ratchet.
Noted, ma'am.
Yeah, but basically it's one of the famous wine towns of Portugal, because Portugal is also known for its famous Porto wine. This is why we decided to set aside 3 days out of our honeymoon to really study the wines of Portugal, because we really want to get to know the culture, and we're such wine connoisseurs that we just can't take me seriously. Kisama ka!
Uy! I was just laughing to other things.
But I'm really, really excited because Yanni was able to find this Quinta do Pacheco,
which is
Quinta do Pacheco, which is a really cute place. The rooms are all shaped in like wine barrels. And I'm so excited because I've seen photos online and it's so cute. And also I'm gonna be spending my birthday there. My birthday sa Lubong will be there, so...
So cute! There are the wine barrel rooms. We're finally all checked in, and these are all the cute wine barrel rooms.
Welcome to my barrel.
Look at how cute it is! Guys! So this is a small sink area, and those are closet spaces. And then here is the bathroom. Beautifully designed. There's a sunroof over there, and we got to control it. Don't you worry. And then, ta-da! We've got the best view in the house. Unobstructed view of Quinta da Pacheca's vineyard. And then they also left us a small port wine. They're doing a lot of upgrades. Like there's gonna be a spa, a pool, more cellars, and then more rooms. But it's already so pretty and so huge. They're one of the oldest vineyards, oldest wineries here in Douro. And they're pretty famous. So I'm so excited because we just booked a wine tasting for tomorrow.
when it's 1 month closer to summer. All this will be green and high, so you can't even see from the parking lot here.
Yeah, you'll just see all this, all greens. Now, because it's still early season, so it's not so high yet. Already so pretty. Just going around the property, looking at what else they have here. It's so big, honestly. Oh, I see the Jusawa. Muni muni moment. Wonder what he's thinking about. All the expenses of this honeymoon. No, just kidding. Oh, there's a peacock. I wanna see your peacock. Cock, cock, your peacock. Oh, showing off. So we're about to have our dinner, but I'm also whispering because everyone seems to be in very hushed voices here. This is the restaurant here at Quinta de Pacheca, and this review. And to start, we got the pork and tonic. Oh, it smells so good. Oh, so good. Attack!
Hey.
My birthday. So good also. This stew is better than this. Morning. Hello. So today has been very, very lazy, which is why after my good morning, I didn't really see anything. And the weather is insanely beautiful today. Like it's 26 degrees, which is so crazy because yesterday was just like kind of cold. So I decided to try to work out. Still trying to convince myself to work out. Think about everything that I've drank and eaten while we are here. I have to work out. I will try to work out. I can do this.
Approved. She really is working out. Good job, Jusawa.
Currently 5:30 p.m. and we're off to do our wine tasting here at Quinta de Pacheca. How many wines are we gonna be able to taste?
I think it's only four.
Four lang?
Maybe more.
As
our
you can
alcoholic
see,
alcoholic here is
what?
Very
shook. I am just a wine
about
connoisseur.
This, about these four wines.
As seen from my beautiful vineyard appropriate outfit. So these where they put all the grapes and they still do it by feet. They still don't use machines. This is how they do the stamping. Oh, that high! Imagine 12 to 15 people there and they're like going around. My goodness, they do it for 4 hours per day. Our guide says that if we came here during the harvest season, during September to October, it would be really fun to show because they show people how they do it here. So they stump their feet with music and dancing while they harvest the wine and they produce all the grapes and stuff. Oh my gosh, I can already smell the grapes and the wine. It smells so good. So this red wine that was just poured for us is this special Pacheca Valle de Abrao. So as you can see here, it's bottle number 4,773. They only produce 5,000 bottles of this per year. So it's super duper special. They don't really put this out as often. And then this one, we have the white wine over here. So it's called the Pacheca Grande Reserva. It's a really a wine that's produced here that uses grapes that it's produced here in Douro. They have to have this sign over there, Douro DOC. This means that they've used exclusively just the grapes that are grown here in Douro Valley. Correct?
Correct.
And now, time to taste. Also smooth, but with a kick. We're now trying the port wines. This is the tawny. So these are more oxidized. They're not red. They're more orangey, rusty. And they can last a really long time. You can have them open for like a year and it's still good. It's usually served chilled. Ready.
Ready.
So port wines are mixed with brandy. In Pacheca, they specifically use brandy from Bordeaux. In Bordeaux. So this one is the tawny. Pretty good. Kasi 40 years na siya. Got 21% alcohol. It smells really, really strong. I don't know if
it's
I like it.
Very,
will
very
I like
sweet.
It?
You will like it. You like strong things.
Oh, so sweet. Oh, very cognac-y na. A little bit. Like a smoky. It's good. My sister will like this. We have now made our purchases.
So what happened?
The Kokoros have now become drunkards.
Just now?
No, we've always been. But responsible drunkards, we bought our very first vintage wine. At first, we were thinking, oh, maybe we shouldn't buy vintage wine. Who are we kidding? We'll probably just drink it and then we won't even appreciate it. We'll be just drinking it like juice. But we said, you know, we're adults now. We're newly married. Might as well invest in a vintage.
correct, and then because it's numbered to 5000, as Madame Camille explained during the tasting, now we are in the end of that year and we were given a bottle for 888,
which is lucky for the Chinese. And I mean, we should buy it because it's for luck,
isn't it? Money,
it's for money. Joa Post.
Update. It's currently 9:40 p.m. and we still have 2.5 hours to go before April 21, which is my birthday. So we are trying our best to stay up. But so far, we haven't been up later than 11 p.m. We've been asleep at 10. But we have to wait because it's my birthday sa Lubong, and that is how we're supposed to celebrate my 31st birthday. But I've been drinking a lot of wine, which is why I've got a natural, lush look. And I've got a husband who's making fun of me. So sad, but we're about to check out now. Can we extend? It's my birthday.
Why extend? We're going to Porto. Porto is fun.
Okay, we're going to Porto now. So we're on our way to check out first, and then we'll head to Porto where I will celebrate my birthday.
Happy birthday to you, Junishang Rukwaila, Palianon Neaban, Palianon Neaban.
Tandaran!
What are you carrying?
From Quinta de Pacheco. We surprised us with more wine.
How about our baggage allowance?
It's okay, we'll figure it out. Arriving to Porto. Look at that view. Oh, so pretty. All checked in. Our room is kind of small, but it's okay because look at this view. You've got the prettiest view of Porto and Louis the First Bridge is right over there. My goodness, I did well, folks. I did well. We're in Porto. It's so pretty. And now we're gonna go explore because today the weather is super duper good. I feel like we're gonna love Porto more than Lisbon. It's already hard to top because we really love Lisbon. But grabe lang. Like, I can't believe this is just 1 cartwheel away from our hotel. We arrived with the perfect weather. Weather talaga plays such a huge role whenever you travel. Of the viewpoint, and there's a bar here, outdoor bar. There's music play. It is such a vibe. I love it.
Where's our picnic blanket?
We need a picnic blanket and order sangria, mojito,
gin and tonic.
Making the most out of our baby-less lives.
First time Madame walks past, she smells popcorn.
Railway station, and look at the interior.
Hi, Madam McDonald's. She wasn't informed, but here she is on her birthday. But we are not here to eat. We came to check it out because we were told it's the prettiest in the world.
It's not true.
What is
McDonald's
not true?
McDonald's in Intramuros is nicer.
Is it? I've never been.
Just kidding. Thank you. Starbucks pala yun. We decided to get McFlurry Snickers. From McDonald's to Mantegoria again. We have to check if it's consistent, right?
No, it's not so hot, but good.
So from the shopping street, we'll see the famous Chapel of Souls. And it's so famous because of this tiled wall. And so many people come here just to take photos. I was one of them. But look at all these intricate tiles. So nice. Now off to have some drinks here at Base Bar.
Breaking news, we're having drinks.
Again, that is the theme of our honeymoon. We still have an hour or two before sunset, so we're just gonna chill here. Sobrang chill namin talaga. Ibang level. To cap off my birthday, we got fancy dinner. Ta-da! Walk to walk! My Asian heart is so happy. My favorite Chinese noodles. Signing off for today, babu. Good afternoon. So we're starting our day really late today because we watched Queer Eye for the Street last night. And that's how I celebrated my birthday. Honestly, the best way, just to Netflix and just to eat inside the room and just be able to have a good laid back and relaxing night.
So now we're off to a vegan or vegetarian restaurant that I found online. They say it's really good and it's a very collaborative type of restaurant. So that piqued my interest. So I told Yanni if we could possibly have that for today's lunch.
So as you can see, people are in puffy jackets and I am in crop top.
But Yanni says it's supposed to be good today. It's supposed to be 18 degrees, right?
Yeah.
Why do people look like they're in winter gear kind of life? Guess I just have to shop.
All the shops are closed because it's Easter.
What? They're still closed?
Easter Monday. Dito to
yan. Do open mo.
Just kidding. The vegetarian place is closed on a Monday. So now we're doing brunch at Do Norte, which kind of reminds Yanni of his home. All the rain here and the wood stuff. You're home, my love. For once, our choice of drink is healthy. No alcohol.
Yes.
Coconut smoothie with banana and strawberry. It's the Carmelite Church. And they've got really cool towels as well. And people are also taking photos here. And we also did because we are true tourists.
It's been raining really, really hard today. And okay lang naman because Yanni and I have been so lazy. We haven't done anything. We went on a lame shopping trip. But yeah, we did nothing. So we just went back to the hotel, changed to proper clothing. We wanted to go back to that bar that we went to yesterday called Base. But it's raining, so we're gonna go look for a wine place instead and drink wine, which is the theme of this honeymoon.
How empty the riverside is now. Looks so dead because of the rain. What a huge difference from yesterday. Honestly, so lucky that yesterday was good weather. We were able to experience Porto all sunny and bright.
We found this cool place again. Oh, it's an antique store and drinks and tapas. Oh, this is so cool. This place though, full of cool stuff. Look at this. Najoa has found something he finds beautiful. This one. This one is also beautiful.
But FIFA World Cup, Mexico, 1986.
Official bag. I like this one with his initials well. Charles Platon, my official PA / bodyguard from Kokoro Wedding. Look at this old school safe. So nice, but oh, it's 1,300 euros. I want one of these. So I've been drinking my wine all joyfully. And then I notice,
look at that car.
Honestly, I keep saying, this is the best antique store I've ever been to. I've been to quite a few here in Europe. And iba, like everything's so well curated. Because usually when you go to antique stores, they have, you know, they're just fillers. You know, baka may mauto. But here, everything is like so well curated. Like they have vintage cameras, vintage tennis rackets, vintage foosball machines, billiard tables, lights, binoculars, like grooming, so good.
Good morning. Today we're out early because we're headed to
library.
The Libreria Lelo, which is a really famous library here because it's so pretty and it inspired J.K. Rowling's Harry Potter. And we've decided to wake up early so that there's not a lot of people yet. What is this uphill cardio in the morning? Oh, but today is really, really freezing cold. It's around like 10 degrees and it's raining.
Miserable.
He is very miserable.
Where did the 27 degrees go?
He's already looking for a sauna.
Oh no, there's already a queue. I came here yesterday during the afternoon and there was also a queue, but I didn't expect this morning's queue to be longer than yesterday afternoon.
It was a struggle. There are 2,700,000 people here.
And I seem to always attract the bright jackets.
Yes.
You just gotta accept that you can't have an empty photo here. We tried to be early, did not work. So, the Jusawa just told me that he booked us a massage.
Spa sesh.
As a surprise honeymoon gift. Thank you, Jusawa.
You're welcome.
I don't know where we're going. I just know there's a pool, there's a scrub that's gonna happen, there's a massage that's gonna happen. Correct?
Correct.
Joa. Oh my gosh, I'm so touched. So we've just seen the tiniest disposables of our lives. Bag siya, guys. So we just finished our scrub and massage. It was good. Dinner. I don't know where.
going to a Chinese restaurant?
No.
Filipino restaurant.
Arroz caldo.
So we got a surprise menu, so we don't really know what we're getting. Some they explain, some they don't. This is the edible margarita.
What's wrong?
It's so sour. It's good.
So you're supposed to eat that, like a shot of tequila.
Miggy Cruz.
Sabi to honeymoon na nga natin, Miggy Cruz pa rin laman na usipan niya. Good? Was it better than tequila shot?
On fire. Because she can't eat the shrimp, she has the avocado tempura.
Oh boy. What is chicken?
Is it chicken skin?
Yeah, hello.
Cheers.
Oh good.
Here's to being alive. I don't know if I mentioned, but this restaurant called Mini Bar is actually by the same chef, the one we tried in this month, which we didn't like. But this one is actually really, really good. Good job, Jose Alvinez. You are now back on our map. Kapela po ka, he's a Michelin chef, and I'm just here judging him. Hindi ko kasi food critic ako eh.
It's good, but out of all the dishes that we tried, this one tastes most normal.
After burning your tongue once, you still pursue the mission. What are you predicting?
I predict your future will be bright.
Yes, queen!
I can also tell that your wife is very beautiful.
Correct, correct.
She brings you luck.
Correct, dragon.
Money. She will also bring you cute coconut babies. I'm not pregnant.
That was a good end to our Portugal trip.
Done.
I know not much has happened.
No, but okay.
Let's start from the beginning.
Can I take over this vlog? Because you're just frozen as hell. So, we went to this place called Mini Bar, as you already know. And we weren't the big fans of the Michelin star chef.
Jose Avilés.
Because of our experience in Lisbon, which wasn't that good. But today, in Mini Bar, we have the tasting menu.
It's a good end to our Portugal honeymoon.
Exactly. So, Jose is back on the map, and we had a good night, and now we're going to sleep. And then we fly out
to Amalfi. We'll see you in our Amalfi vlog. For now, thank you so much. Please leave a comment below. Give us a thumbs up. We'll see you in Amalfi.
Baboo.